Today in the shop, I am going to show you how to update a Sync3 system running version 3.0 to version 3.4 and update the navigation system for free. Today's vehicle is a 2018 Lincoln Navigator, and if we look at the About Sync screen, we can see it's a Sync3 system running version 3.0 and build 17302. And if we go to Ford's website, it shows it on Sync version 3.0, build 17302, and says the Sync system is up to date. It already has the newest level installed. So we are going to be using a free aftermarket app from Cyan Labs to update this Sync system to version 3.4 and update the navigation system to the newest level at the same time. I'm going to start by downloading the Sync3 Updater app from Cyan Labs' website. And from the main page, we're going to click the View Application button. And then I'm going to scroll down to the very bottom of this page and click on the Downloads button. I'm going to click on the Sync3 Updater installer, and our app's going to start downloading. Once the app's finished downloading, I'm going to go ahead and open it, and you should get a screen that looks like this. We're going to need to check the box at the bottom that says we understand the above disclaimer, and that should take us to the car configuration screen. I'm going to go ahead and fill in the box with the current version of Sync this system has, which is 3.0.17302. And then I'm going to select the region, which is going to be the United States, Canada, and Mexico. I'm going to set the language to English, and I'm going to leave the theme light. I'm going to leave the release branch on stable because I like things to work. I'm going to click on the navigation button and change it from no to yes because this vehicle definitely has navigation. And I'm going to click the apply settings button at the bottom right of the screen. And that brings us to this screen where we can choose where our software update is going to download to. I'm going to select a 64GB flash drive that I've installed, and I'd recommend you use at least a 32GB flash drive, but you probably can get away with something smaller depending on what update you are installing. That brings us to the new version section where we can actually choose what software updates we want to install. And all of the boxes here are going to be drop-down menus where you can actually choose and select the software updates you want from the settings for the system you've already entered. For my region, I'm going to select the United States, Canada, and Mexico. For my version, I'm going to select the newest version that it shows is compatible, and that's going to be version 3.4, build 22251. Once you've selected a version of Sync, a box is going to appear on the right side of the screen, and that's going to tell you any relevant information about that Sync version, what improvements it contains, any known issues with it, anything relevant that you need to know about it. And that just leaves us with the map version we're going to choose to install, and I'm going to select 2.21. That's the newest map that's currently available. I'm not going to mess with any of the packages that's pre-selected to download in this software update, and I wouldn't recommend you do unless you really know what you're doing. And we do have the option of only downloading the files here, but I'm going to click the Start button, and it's going to create an installation utility, and that is going to give us a very large, very red warning message. This app cannot be used on 2020 model year or newer Sync modules, and that includes if a vehicle has had a Sync module replaced. This vehicle still has the original 2018 Sync module, so I'm going to select no. That's going to give us a warning message that all the current data on our flash drive is going to be erased. We're going to click yes. And that's it. It's going to start downloading the files and creating our flash drive. And this is going to take quite a while.
2 hours later.
After it's all done downloading, we're going to get this pop-up that's going to ask if we'd like to upload a log after we do our update to help with diagnostics. And I'm going to select no. And that's going to give us another pop-up that says our flash drive is ready to be ejected and installed in the vehicle. And you will need to start the vehicle and have it running during installation. This is going to take at least half an hour to install. So you're going to need the vehicle outside or in a well-ventilated area or be able to put an exhaust hose on it. If your vehicle shuts down after an extended period of idle, which is most of them, you're going to need to go into the instrument cluster and disable this feature, or you're going to have to step on the brake pedal and put it in gear and then back in park every 15 minutes. I've started the engine on this, and we're going to give it just a minute for the Sync system to boot up and stabilize. Once our system is stabilized, I'm going to go ahead and install our flash drive in one of the front USB ports, and it doesn't matter which USB port you insert it into. Within a minute or two of installing the flash drive in the USB port, we should see a message on our screen that says updating system software, and then the system's going to go ahead and reboot. You will get a message that says you may now remove your USB device. Whatever you do, do not remove your USB device. And then the system is going to boot back up, and you're going to get this screen. And I have to admit, I actually like the updating screen better on this than on a Ford Sync update. On a Ford Sync update, you just get the updating system at the top of the screen, and 2 hours later you're looking at it and wondering if the system is locked up, if it's still updating, if it's doing anything. This one actually has a status bar that goes across and shows you its progress. At this point, we can just walk away from the vehicle and leave it to do its thing. We'll check back on it periodically. The important thing is that the vehicle does not shut down, but if it does, you should be able to restart your update. Once the installation is complete, you'll get this green screen along with a message that says update successful, please remove USB. And this installation took 35 minutes. And I know that because it tells you at the bottom right of the screen. Once you remove your flash drive, the system should automatically reboot. If it doesn't, you need to go ahead and shut the vehicle off and open a door so the sync system shuts down and give it 10 seconds and then restart the vehicle. And yes, the screen size is now wrong, so I will show you how to fix that in just a minute. I'm going to go ahead and select Ask Me Later for do I want to turn on the following features. And I'm going to go ahead and perform a master reset now just to make sure we don't have any glitches left in the system from the large software download we just did.
A few moments later.
With our master reset done, that just leaves us with our screen size issue. And what's causing our screen size problem is that on the older versions of Sync 3, the as-built code for a 10-inch touchscreen was a 3. And on the later versions, like 3.4, which we've installed here, the as-built data for a 10-inch touchscreen is a 7. So we're going to use Forscan and go in and fix our as-built data and correct it for the touchscreen size. We're already connected to the vehicle. I'm going to go ahead and press the Configure and Programming button on the left. And then we're going to click on APIM Module Configuration, as-built Format, and click the little run icon at the bottom of the screen. We'll get the warning message that says changing as-built data may screw up your car. I'm going to click OK. And this is the as-built data that's currently in our sync module. 7D0 is the identifier for the sync module. We need block 3. There's only one line in block 3. On that line, we're going to alter the second box with 4 hexadecimal characters in it. We need to alter the first two characters, and currently they're 03, and we need to change that to 07. This is also going to cause the checksum, the last two characters on this line, to change. And I could have ran this through a checksum calculator and figured out what it was going to be. But if I just go ahead and write the line, it's going to correct it. So let's go ahead and click the write button for block 3. And we get a nice pop-up that says the checksum is not correct. I'm going to go ahead and click yes, continue anyway.
Just do it!
It'll take just a second for it to write the block back to our sync module. And we get a blocks program successfully cycled the ignition off and on message. And if you take a quick look at block 3, the block we just wrote, our checksum has changed from E1 to E5, which is the correct checksum for this line, so it auto-corrected it. So let's go ahead and cycle the ignition off and back on. And I do believe now we have a correctly sized display on our touchscreen. I'm going to select no, and we're going to go ahead and make sure the home screen looks correct, and it does. Let's go ahead and jump back to our laptop for a second. I'm going to go ahead and click OK. I'm going to go ahead and click the stop button at the bottom of the screen to get us out of our as-built configuration. I'm going to click the vehicle icon in the very top left corner, and then I am going to go to the bottom of that page and click the disconnect from vehicle button. Let's go to the About Sync screen and check our sync version number. Sync 3, version 3.4, build 22251. And our navigation is now at 2.21. If you found this helpful or interesting, please click the like button down below. I got a lot more great stuff coming up, so please subscribe. And as always, have a great week.